would like to address the congressman here as well as the audience over something that people are becoming increasingly familiar with. New Year's Eve, while we were all home with our families, kicking back the eggnog, Barack Obama signed a bill called the National Defense Authorization Act. Now, in this bill, it is the most unconstitutional piece of legislation that has ever been passed. It states that the executive branch, Barack Obama, can deploy the U.S. military against the citizenry. It states that American citizens on U.S. soil can be indefinitely detained without habeas corpus or right to trial, and stripped of their citizenship, deported, and worse. Now, if this does not actually create the kind of Abraham Lincoln reflex that we need today, that we are a government of, for, and by the people, and the kinds of people that we've elected, such as Brad Sherman, who voted on this piece of legislation, that that is a reflection of us. He voted yay on this legislation.
Now, let me address that.
Now, my question for you is, when do you plan on resigning?
Changes in it and indicating he would veto it if it was half as bad as this gentleman described it. The bill that I voted against in June was about half as bad as your description. The bill that I voted for in December and that the president signed still had some bad aspects to it. But what you didn't say in your question was, before that statute was passed, what was the standard? And in fact, things were worse before the statute than after. What happened is the courts noticed that we have a war on terrorism and started creating some very extreme doctrines of the type that you would strongly disagree with. There is an attempt to put into statute those doctrines in a way that reduces them and cuts them. That was a bad job of drafting in June. By December, it was far from perfect, but considerably better. And yes, you can say there is vague language in the December statute that poses a risk to civil liberties. But you also have to say that there is language in that bill that replaces judicial doctrines that were more vague and more dangerous. But that doesn't mean that this law is adequate. I have co-sponsored two different bills to solve the problem and to give us the civil liberties that we ought to have in this country. It, as a matter of history, and no, you don't get to grant the microphone again, I'm sorry, I've got a lot of people ask questions, but what's interesting as a matter of history is Abraham Lincoln was perhaps our greatest president, but I believe he's the only president to suspend habeas corpus. And of course, that was a civil war. We can argue that. No president today could or would, and no court would allow suspending habeas corpus or the other possible infringements on our liberty. There is language in the bill that we got added at the last minute that the blogosphere didn't notice that said that these provisions do not apply to U.S. citizens on U.S. soil. But I will agree with you. The doctrines that we had 6 months ago and 6 years ago that grew out of the Afghan War Resolution and the statute that we have in force today have some problems with it, and that's why I've co-sponsored your amendments bill and a second bill to fully solve those problems.